Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Sue Donham is tracked down of a curious caravan. Riders wanted. Share expenses. Starring Peter Lupus. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. Also by State Farm Insurance, International Harvester, and Quaker State Motor Oil. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
We are living in a paradoxical time. The jet age slowed by a fuel shortage. We must learn to retain our mobility through group travel. Today, the story of a journey. Five strangers together in one car. Four of them are what they appear to be. But there is one among them who is not. That one stranger is a killer. And now, riders wanted. Share expenses.
Is this Leon's diner?
Who's asking?
My name's Dunn. Teddy Dunn. This ad in the paper says riders wanted. Share expenses, destination Florida, inquire Leon's diner.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Nancy!
Don't shout, Leon.
Oh, I didn't know he was right there. This fella here is looking for a ride to Florida.
I don't know how far exactly, but Florida's in the right direction.
Well, we got room for one more. Are you willing to chip in for gas and food and maybe a campsite or two?
As long as my money holds up.
How soon can you be ready?
Right now. Everything I own is right here in this knapsack.
Well, we'll be taking my car. Come on, I'll introduce you to the others. My name's Nancy Etheridge. What's yours?
Teddy Dunn.
Pretty lady, what do you say we hit the road?
Right away. But first I want you all to meet Teddy Dunn. He'll be going with us.
Another passenger? Well, won't it be awful crowded?
Well, Mr. Dunn will be helping out money-wise, so I guess we can bunch up some. Teddy, this is Joe Don Brady.
I didn't mean nothing personal by it.
And this is Albert Moran.
Which you prefer, Mr. Dunn or Teddy?
I keep to myself mostly, you know.
Oh.
And this here's Lucy Sims.
Howdy do.
Well, I guess we're all acquainted. Let's get started. Goodbye, Leon. And thanks for everything.
Well, now you have a safe trip now.
Nancy,
there's a job here waiting for you if you ever decide to come back. You hear?
I hear. Take care now.
Well, here's the Vernon Lipscomb file.
Thanks, Russ.
That's quite a list of aliases for a jewel thief.
Lipscomb's more than that. He's a fugitive. Walked out of prison upstate. He was doing 10 to 20 for armed robbery and attempted murder.
Wow. I wish we had a more recent photograph of him.
Psychiatrist's report calls Lipscomb a borderline mental case.
Sam, why would he head south? He can't be that loony.
Well, the word is Lipscomb's heading for the border. He'll probably work his way east and then try to slip across at El Paso or maybe Brownsville.
You think he's here now?
I don't know, Russ. Better check the bus depots and the flea bag hotels in the Tenderloin District. That seems to be his pattern. Oh, and make a copy of that photograph before you leave.
Right.
Mr. Dunn, would you mind terribly rolling up your window? That wind's blowing mighty hard back here.
It's too hot. Wait till we get out of the desert.
I'm very uncomfortable.
I'm sorry.
Hey, fella, the lady asked you nice. Now, why don't
hey
you...
Hey, now, Mac, who asked
oh,
you?
Oh, now, partner, we ain't even left California yet.
Yes, we have. That was the border.
Anyone hungry?
I'm starved.
I could stand a cheeseburger. How about you, Lucy?
Mr. Dunn, the window.
Teddy, please.
There. You satisfied?
Thank you.
We'll stop for gas and food in Kingman. If we're lucky, we can make it as far as Flagstaff by midnight.
McSwain.
Sam, we're in luck, maybe.
What do you mean, Russ?
I found the hotel where Lipscomb's been, but he's gone.
How long?
A day.
That's not too bad.
Ah, I got something else. The desk clerk says Lipscomb asked him if he knew anything about those share the ride deals leaving town. Bought himself a Sunday paper and checked out.
Good work, Russ. Come on back. By the time you get here, I'll have a list made up from the ads.
I'm on my way.
Why are we stopping?
Can't drive with my eyes closed, and they're closing.
Well, I can drive.
Just what is your hurry, Wendy?
I'm tired.
Oh, be reasonable, Mr. Dunn. Accidents happen at night.
What do you say, Nancy?
Well, this is a rest area. That's what it's for.
Oh, I'm taking a walk.
He's had a hair up his nose ever since we left.
I don't like him.
Well, Mr. Dunn has the look of a man chasing after something.
You got the right idea there, Albert, except you got it backward. I say Dunn's a man being chased.
Sam, we've been all morning running down these ads. I sure could use a bite.
Leon's Diner's next on the list. If it doesn't pan out, we'll grab a meal there.
How far away is it?
Oh, about 10 feet.
Oh. Who are we looking for?
The ad doesn't say. How about him?
Hey, Albert, get out here and fill this table now.
Excuse me. I wonder if you could tell me something about this ad in the paper.
Who's asking? Oh, cops.
That's right.
Well, friend, you're a little late. They left yesterday.
Was this man one of them?
Huh? Well, I can't tell for sure. Not much of a picture, is it? Oh, yeah. Now I recognize him. Hair's longer, but that's him, all right. What's he done?
He broke out of prison.
You mean it? Well, that makes it bad for Nancy, doesn't it?
Who's Nancy?
The girl who put that in the paper. Nancy Etheridge, best waitress I ever had.
How many passengers did Miss Etheridge have in her car?
Oh, how many passengers? Now, wait a minute. Let me see there. There was him in the picture, and a couple other guys, and the two women. That's five altogether.
Yeah, well, what kind of a car did they leave in?
Oh, no, I couldn't say that. Now, the black sedan, though, I know that. I don't know the make of the model. Nancy bought it used, you see, just of day.
You know where she bought it?
No, I don't know where she bought it.
Do you know where they're headed?
Well, east as far as Florida. I think her family lives there, you see.
She married?
Well, she was. He died. They got a kid, though. In fact, she said she was going to pick the kid up on the way. The boy lives with her sister-in-law.
Where?
Oh, Texas, someplace.
Texas is a big state.
Yeah, I know. I remember the town, if I heard it. No?
Houston, Dallas, El Paso, San Antonio.
No. That's it. El Paso.
Sam, I am really hungry.
Well, you can grab a sandwich around town while you're checking out used car lots.
Used car lots?
Nancy Etheridge bought a black sedan recently. Try to find out where. Get a description and a license number. I'll alert the Border Patrol at El Paso with the information we have so far.
Sam, you don't think Lipscomb's going to do anything to those people in the car, do you?
I'd like to find him before he gets a chance.
You know, Lucy, maybe it was luck that we stopped at this station when we did.
How much do shock absorb his cost?
I have enough.
Hey there, pretty ladies. How are we doing?
Oh, it'll take an hour, Joe Don.
Where did Mr. Moran and Mr. Dunn go?
They headed into town.
Together?
No. They were even going in different directions. I think I'll head in myself. Any of you ladies care to join me?
I better wait here.
With you.
Okay. I'll be back in an hour.
Well, the car's ready. All we need now are the passengers.
Mr. Moran's in the washroom. Oh, here comes Joe Don.
All set?
Just about.
Hope it wasn't too expensive.
Are we ready to push off?
Ding.
We're waiting for Mr. Dunn.
Well, he's not back yet?
Maybe he got restless and run off.
We better wait a bit.
He had his knapsack with him. I saw him in town.
Oh, here he comes now.
Hey, what's everybody looking at me for?
I ain't looking.
Here you are. Say it. What's on your mind, cowboy?
Not done. You've been asking for trouble the whole time.
Oh, no, no, please. Friends. Let's just leave.
Good idea. Joe Don, sit up front. Teddy, hop in the back.
Just like children.
Well, I struck out, Sam. I've been to 40 car lots. Nothing sold in Nancy Etheridge. Oh, I'm sorry.
In Gallup. How long ago? Right. Thanks.
What's up?
Plenty. Lipscomb's been in Gallup, New Mexico.
Well, how do you know?
There was a jewelry store robbery and a shooting. The store manager identified Lipscomb by the wire photo, then lapsed into a coma. They think he's going to die.
Here's the turnoff, Nancy.
Hey, where are you going?
El Paso.
Past? Since when?
Well, Nancy's going to pick up her young son. You were asleep when she mentioned it.
You could get out and hitchhike.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Please don't start, you two. I'm trying to concentrate on my driving.
No luck?
No time. The car's got to be registered with the state, but by the time we locate the papers, Lipscomb could be halfway to South America. I figure there's somewhere between Albuquerque and El Paso already.
This is pretty tight, Sam.
We got nothing on the car, and not much of a make on Lipscomb either. That guy at the diner had a rough time recognizing him from the picture when... Wait a minute. The diner.
The diner? What about it?
That's a long shot, but we got to try it. You got your pills?
My pills?
For air sickness. We're flying to Texas in half an hour.
Oh, not again.
What is it, Nancy?
I'm exhausted. We all are. Lucy's asleep, so is Joe Don.
So I noticed.
How far are we from your sister-in-law's?
An hour. Two, maybe.
Boy, look, why don't we switch places? You rest, I'll drive, all right?
Oh, you don't know the way.
No, it's a shame to be so close and yet so far. Perhaps we can stop for coffee soon.
Well, I'm getting out. I need to stretch my legs.
Oh, careful, you're waking
me up. What is...
You were on my knapsack.
But where are you going?
What's it to you?
You're not in the car, fella. Yeah, don't break it up. Hey, that's my valise. Give it back to me.
What?
Where did all this jewelry come from?
Yeah.
I stole it. And I shot a man who tried to stop me.
Albert, you...
Well, I'm a dangerous criminal, or so I'm told. Nobody move now. You two, back out of the car now, very slowly. Well, that's it. Yeah.
What are you going to do with us?
Well, I don't want to hurt you ladies. You just do as I say, and everything will work out fine. Nancy, drive.
That's the border up ahead.
What are all those lights?
I don't know.
No, turn the car around. We're going back.
Back where?
Our first destination. We're going to visit your little boy. Ladies, after you.
Albert, I'm asking you not to do this.
Oh, I haven't done anything yet.
Let us go. We won't tell.
Please don't bring my little boy into this, Albert. I'll drive you anywhere else.
I'm sorry, Nancy. I truly am, but we're all along for the ride, you know. I have to ask you to share the expenses.
get out of the car. Move now. No tricks.
Albert, please.
I'll tell you what. Nancy, if I get out of this, I'm going to give you the jewelry. All of it.
You can give the jewelry back.
Oh, no. No, I can't. I can't go back. They'll put me away for good. You see, I've been away before. There's no getting out anymore.
Albert.
Enough.
I'm not going any further.
He'll shoot us.
You listen to Lucy now.
I don't care. Not one more step.
All right, I'll make it as painless as...
Let's get him, freeze!
You know something, Sam? You'd really make a great gambler. Your long shots always seem to pay off.
I don't like to gamble with people's lives. If Nancy Etheridge hadn't sent that postcard to Leon, well, the gamble would have failed.
Oh, we could have let Lipscomb through at the border.
There was no guarantee the others would have survived. We needed to turn him back. It was the address on the postcard. Oh, we were lucky, all right.
By the way, you got a postcard today from Nancy Etheridge.
What's it say?
Do you think I read your mail? Well, says she's had enough of Florida and she's coming back.
Wouldn't you know it?
And no riders this trip.
How's that?
She's flying.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Riders Wanted, Share Expenses is an original radio drama adapted by Sue Donham. Peter Lucas was heard as Sam McSwain. Featured in the cast were Dick Perrin, Julie Bennett, Casey Kasem, Tommy Cook, and Hans Conry. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood with a mutual broadcasting system by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.